Hey, what is going on, you guys? Welcome back to the channel. So today we're going to be talking about the five steps you need to follow when you get paid. So we got the bank behind me here. We're going to go ahead and pretend it's payday. And so the very first step that most people follow is they go to the bank and they cash their paycheck. And we're going to talk about the five things that you should be doing immediately after that. All right, guys, so the very first step that you want to follow when you get paid actually comes from this book right here. It's called The Richest Man in Babylon, which is one of the best books I've ever read out there just on basic money skills. I'll go ahead and link up to it in the description below if you guys want to check it out. But this is a concept called pay yourself first. And where people go wrong when they get paid is they oftentimes immediately start paying everybody else except for themselves. They pay the cable company, they pay the utility company, they pay for their mortgage. And I'm not saying don't pay for these things, because obviously you have to. But what I'm saying instead is on payday, you immediately take a portion of your paycheck out from your total paycheck and you set that aside in your savings. Now, you don't have to go crazy with this at first. In fact, you could start with just 1% or 2% of your paycheck, but you want to get in this habit of on payday, taking a chunk of that money and setting it aside for yourself. Now, most experts out there recommend saving and investing anywhere from 5 to 20% of your paycheck. And I know that's a lot of money for most people. So again, you can just start with just 1 or 2%, but I definitely recommend working your way up from there. And one thing I will recommend is you take this money and you're going to put it in a separate savings account. There's a number of different online savings accounts out there. I'll actually link up to one in the description that currently pays about a 2% APY, which is a lot higher interest than you're going to get from a traditional bank out there. But you're going to put that in a separate savings account. That way you don't confuse it with any other money out there. This is going to be your emergency fund or your rainy day fund. And the first goal you should have for yourself is to save up $1,000 in this account that will serve as your emergency fund. So just to recap here, step number one when you get paid is to pay yourself first. And if you don't have it already, begin building up that emergency fund. All right, so step number two when you get paid is a simple one, but a lot of people don't think of it. And that is to go to the gas station and fill your car up with gas. So a lot of people don't think of this, and this is what they end up doing. They get their paycheck on Friday, they cash that paycheck, they go out and blow money all weekend, and then Monday morning comes around, they're rushing to work and they realize that they have no gas. So they end up going to the gas station and filling up their gas tank using their credit card. So on Friday, on payday, right after you pay yourself, the next step is go to the gas station and fill your tank up with gas because you're going to need it anyway. All right, so step number three when you get paid is a simple one, but that is to go to the grocery store. So I wanted to show you guys just how much more money you spend by buying fast food versus making stuff from the grocery store. So I actually just ran through Dunkin' Donuts and I bought like a basic breakfast sandwich and a coffee. And now we're gonna buy those exact same supplies at the grocery store and compare the cost of both of these. All right, guys, so we went ahead and prepared our replica breakfast sandwich here of the one that we just bought at Dunkin' Donuts. Just to recap for you guys, we ended up spending $6.83 for a Dunkin' Donuts breakfast sandwich and a medium coffee. And that price broke down to $3.99 for the breakfast sandwich you see here, which is obviously ham, egg, and cheese on an English muffin. And then it was $2.39 for the coffee. So we were able to stock up on a number of different items while we were at the grocery store. For example, English muffins were actually buy one, get two free. So we ended up getting 18 of those, and you can literally just pop those extra English muffins in the freezer and they're gonna be good for a lot longer. You just thaw them as needed for the week. So we spent $4.49 on 18 English muffins, which works out to 25 cents per English muffin per breakfast sandwich. We also picked up a dozen eggs for $1.49, which ends up being a price of about 12 cents per egg. Next up, we picked up a good amount of ham for $5.39. Now, the smallest one we could find was about 1 pound, and so we divided that out across 5 days, which is about how long ham is good for, and that ends up being $1.07 per serving on our breakfast sandwich. But if you wanted to be even cheaper, you could definitely cut back on the ham. And then finally, the big area where we're saving money is making coffee at home. We got about 1 pound of coffee for $2.99, which we can actually make 68 servings of coffee with if we want to be as frugal as possible, which ends up being a price of just 4 cents per cup of coffee versus $2.39 from Dunkin' Donuts. So for this meal right here that you're looking at, we're spending $1.48 per meal versus spending over 4 times more at Dunkin' Donuts, which ends up costing $6.83 per meal. So the big thing that I like to do is look at the savings over the course of 1 year. And if you do this 5 days per week, make your breakfast at home rather than buying your breakfast out, the exact savings is $1,391 per year is what you can save by simply eating one meal at home versus buying breakfast. And not to mention, most people buy both breakfast and lunch out of the house, so you could easily double that savings by doing exactly this, but also doing the same thing for lunch and bringing your own lunch to work. All right, guys, so step number four when you get paid is, in my opinion, one of the most important ones, because this is an area where people totally just blow all of their money, and that is your entertainment expenses. So what I actually recommend doing is not only having a budget for your entertainment expenses, but actually take that money out of the bank, and I'm a big fan of the envelope system, and literally put that money inside an envelope labeled entertainment expenses. So right here I have $100 cash. Let's say, for example, that was my entertainment expenses for the next 2 weeks. Well, what you would do is when you're going out to the bar or when you're going out for a meal with your girlfriend or whatever, you're gonna take that money out of this envelope. And then the key is, and this is where most people go wrong, once the envelope is empty, you don't spend any more money on entertainment until you replenish that envelope on your next payday. So figure out in advance what you're going to be spending on entertainment if you get paid weekly or bi-weekly, adjust accordingly, and then set that money aside, put it in an envelope labeled entertainment, and only spend what it is that you have here. And as an advantage, if you want to, you could definitely save that money for a couple of weeks and let it accumulate, and then spend your money on a larger entertainment expense. All right, guys, and number five, the fifth and final step when you get paid after you followed the steps prior is to start paying off some of your debt. Now, a lot of people may argue with me on this one as far as should you be saving money before you start paying off debt, and I think you should have a $1,000 cash cushion saved up as a minimum before you start paying off your debt, because as good as it would be to put the majority of your paycheck towards your debt, well, if next week you turn around and you have to swipe that credit card again, you're gonna be in that exact same situation. Now, there's basically two schools of thought when it comes to paying down your debt. Number one is to simply pay off the highest interest debt first, which is what makes most sense financially. But the strategy a lot of people actually like to follow these days is to pay off the smallest dollar amount first. So let's say you had maybe a $200 Walmart credit card. Maybe you would pay that off first because you can knock that right out pretty easily and establish that momentum. But that's up to you guys, whatever strategy makes more sense to you. But once you follow these other steps and you have that emergency fund in place, it's now time to begin paying off that debt and eventually getting to a point where you don't have any of that bad debt, the credit card debt or the medical bills or things like that. But anyways, guys, that's gonna wrap up this video. Those are the five steps that I recommend taking when you get paid. Let me know what you think down in the comment section below. Do you agree with these steps or do you disagree? I'm curious what you guys think about that. And if you're new to this channel and you're looking for more tips and advice about money saving and investing and things related to that nature, make sure you subscribe and hit that bell for notifications of future uploads. But thanks so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it and I will see you in the next one.